Hey guys, Dagan from PMTV UK here, winning NAMM 2016. And I'm with the legendary Bryan from Dunlop. How's it going, dude?
Can you hear the angels crying?
I can hear them, they're weeping.
Little diamond tears.
Diamond tears, man. I love it. So how's the show been for you already, man?
It's been good. I mean, it's Friday, so I still got 2 more days to screw everything up and just destroy my body, but...
It happens. You know, it's part of the fun of the show.
It's good to see old friends and play new stuff.
Yeah, that's why we're all here, man, the new stuff.
What I was just playing right there is our new reverb, which is pretty amazing. There's 6 different reverbs in there. There's a plate, a spring, there's an epic, which is a hall.
Nice.
A modulated reverb, a room, and then what we were just playing was the pad that has the octaves. And if you like, you can turn the tone knob and get the octave low. For these pads. Pretty epic.
That's what I'm talking about.
You can get into this pedal, and I got lost for hours. They're like, get to work. Wait, I'm working.
Keep finding new shit.
Yeah, so another cool function is the expression out.
Right, cool.
Goes into our new DBP4 volume pedal.
Sweet.
You flip the switch on the inside into the auxiliary input, and it can either be a dedicated tuner out. In this case, it's an expression out.
Nice.
So I set the reverb the way I want to. Here's a nice little spring. And so, you know. So now I want to go crazy Dick Dale.
Right.
Toe all the way down, adjust the reverb, and we go crazy Dick Dale. Back to the original reverb.
That's so cool, man.
They can blend it in. Versatility, a lot of useful functions. TSR cable stereo in if you'd like.
Yeah.
TSR cable stereo out if you'd like. You can program it to have trails when you turn it off, or you can go true bypass and not have that. Analog dry pass, so anything that's not being affected by the reverb is all analog all the way through.
Cool. You guys
I think that's about it. I think there's something else in there that I'm forgetting, but I don't know.
We'll put links in. Have a little gander yourselves.
So cool. It's just a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So the next one I want to show you is, this is a riot. If you get a shot on the Way Huge Overrated Special.
All right, I've been waiting for this pedal personally for a while, and I've just had some news.
So there's a bit of sense of humor on this one. Here's the story.
Right.
Joe Bonamassa is changing his whole rig up for his last tour. No more big, giant pedal boards with all the stuff on it. Now he's got a wah-wah pedal, his signature wah-wah pedal, and he was using a very famous, well-known overdrive that a lot of people know and love.
Yes.
So George says, why don't I just make you something that's going to be a little more custom for you that'll give you what you need? He says, yeah, that'd be great, a 500 hertz cut and boost on top of that old-school circuit. So George took his Green Rhino, classic Green Rhino, added the 500 hertz cut and boost, and then they use this font that is pretty famous. And so Joe thought that was a kicker. He made 3 custom pedals for him. Joe took a picture of it. It went on the social media.
It destroyed the web.
And what happened? It broke the web.
It did.
And so the market, the people spoke. They demanded
I was one of them.
The overrated special. And so we made a limited amount, I think 500 or not exactly sure if it's 5 or 1,000, but once they're done, they're done. So it's, you know, a basic, that's dry. Put a little sauce on it. That's the story of the overrated special.
Beautiful.
You can't accuse us for not having a sense of humor.
Yeah, you guys have always had a sense of humor, man, with your stuff. It's fantastic.
So another thing we have here is John Petrucci. I still got Joe Bonamassa on my mind. John Petrucci uses our rack wall.
Yeah.
And we wanted to do something special for him. So what we did is we took his settings from his rack wall and put it into his signature wall. Nice smoke chrome finish. There's indicator lights on both sides, so wherever you are on the stage, you can see. But here's the cap. Here's the catch. Or here's the capper. So on the rack wall, there's a 6-band EQ, a volume adjustment, and a Q adjustment, all internal inside the pedal. You take the back plate off, it comes factory set to John Petrucci's settings.
Right.
But when you get it, you take it home, take that back plate off, adjust it however you want. You can make it over the top, you can make it, you know, it's a versatile wall.
That's a great idea.
The way he uses it, he likes it with a pretty dirty amp. I'm running this EVH through this car. And then so he uses it as an expression. So he doesn't really do a lot of waka waka waka. He's using it as an expression, kind of finding those notch frequencies. So that brings us to my favorite wah-wah pedal.
And my favorite wah-wah pedal.
So for a long time, I've been using the bass Crybaby on my board as a guitar player. That's my favorite wah-wah pedal. Yeah. I've been preaching all across the lands and over the seas.
I hear you. I've been doing exactly the same thing to all of my friends at home. Use a bass wah through a guitar.
And they're like, no, it's bass. Whatever. It sounds great. That's my favorite. So they came out with the mini bass wah right down here, the little white fellow. And they were just going to put it on the baseboard. And I said, no. You're putting it on, I'm putting that on the guitar board because that's my favorite one. It's very expressive. It's like a filter. Love that thing.
It's great.
So much fun.
So please, I got someone to share that passion with, the love of bass wars.
God bless you, young man. Well, I think that's about it. We can talk a little about the Echoplex.
Yeah, let's do that, man.
The Echoplex is, it'll be available later on this year. It is, sounds exactly like the EP3 that we have at the office. That's basically what it is. Sustain for the amount of echoes in return, delay time, volume is like a mix knob. How much echo you want? Tap tempo. Ta-da!
So you, 2016.
Yeah. So you have a tap tempo in there. The other thing is it has this degradation knob. So right here is just what it sounds like. Kind of have a little, turn the reverb off. Degraded a bit. But then when you push this volume knob down and it blinks, now you turn it up, and now it sounds like a destroyed tape with the wow and the flutter. You can get all reggae on it. Get all Radiohead.
Some great sounds here, man.
Hold on, the mothership is landing. Take me to your leader. So, basically, ladies and gentlemen, Dunlop Manufacturing makes and sells fun.
Yeah, fun in a box. That's Can't be said better than that. Thanks again, dude. Wow. Awesome as always.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Cheers, guys.